Well, Yarmouk, as I remember it, was a very beautiful, but now I can't say the same thing. I mean, when I watch all these videos on like Facebook, it's so heartbreaking because, like, for example, Palestine Mosque now, it's all bombed up. And I remember as a kid, I used to like go to, when it's Eid, I used to go and like play with the other kids and my cousins and friends and stuff. And now it's just, it's rubble, isn't it? It's supposed to be a place of worship, but it's gone.
Samer Mahmoud Nassar died of a lack of medical care following a shrapnel injury.
Suhair Sinan died of starvation.
Mohammed Ahmed Abdul Al-Ghami died of starvation.
Mahmoud Mohammed Ayadi died of starvation.
Mohammed Hamad Hassan, 14 days, starvation.
Jana Ahmed Hassan, starvation.
Ahmed Adwan, starvation.
It's 2015, it's, you know, this is, people need to be looking into this, people need to be angry, people need to know that just because they live comfortably, just because they're not expecting a shell to hit them and their kids any time at night, it doesn't mean we can't think about it. We always need to feel the pain of other people all the time. All that's so important, so vital. It just keeps you in touch with your humanity, doesn't it?
It's very difficult to make people understand what's happening in Yarmouk. I think, for me as somebody who's from the outside but has lived there and has experienced it as a normal place, of course it was a refugee camp, and in many ways that isn't and shouldn't be normal. This is a community that was forced out of their homes following the foundation of Israel in 1948. They're living as stateless refugees with no citizenship anywhere in the world. My husband doesn't have citizenship of any country. But in other ways, it was a very lively, vibrant, alive place. We call it a camp. But it's been there since the 50s, so it was very built up. There are banks. Everyone in Damascus say, like, oh, it's the best place to go and buy clothes, go and buy shoes, cafes. We went to parties. We spent a lot of time just hanging out, socializing with friends and family. The Yarmouk is somewhere where people can die of starvation, where people we know can die of starvation. And when you see these devastating images of, you know, it just looks like post-apocalyptic, schools shelled, houses shelled, people searching through rubbish bins looking for food. It's very difficult to communicate.
I just feel like more people need to know, more people need to care, just because it's not a country they come from or just because they don't have personal affiliation with it doesn't mean that it doesn't matter to them. And for Palestine being displaced twice, I mean, we don't need another Gaza. We already have a Gaza that's under siege. I think we've had enough. Palestinians have just had enough. They need security, they need peace, they need to know that people care about them. And I think we lack that so much. We lack the fact that we have a home to call ours, and it's really heartbreaking for me. It's really heartbreaking.
It's surprising to me that it's not a bigger story, that in 2015, in a country that wasn't rich but wasn't poor, children can die of starvation, and it doesn't seem that interesting to people.